Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Give yourselves a round of applause. Proudly presenting the Miss Senior DC Pageant 2016 opening number, Keys of Life, featuring Monica Carroll, the Miss Senior DC Pageant choreographer, the MC Steppers, Mary McCoy, Miss Senior DC 2012, Miss Senior DC Wendy Bridges, and the Miss Senior DC Pageant contestants 2016. Narration by my good friend, Sandra Beers. Please give her a welcome. Miss Senior DC 2005.
Thank you. Today's world presents us with new challenges, promising to offer the answer to the age-old question, what's next? Knowing beyond life and exploring ideas. But does life tip the balance against despair? The fights, the struggles, growing and learning, the reality of the world. Today, the pageant will tell us a story about the key of life through the music of Stevie Wonder. Watch, listen, and learn. Thank you.
My key of life: belief produces a key. Trust shows you the door. Action unlocks the door that enables you to step outside.
Hey, man. How you doing, baby?
What's going on?
Living life like it's golden.
All right, I know you are. Well, you know, the key of life that I go by is to always put God first. Love one another. Give generously. And always be kind. You know, because life is a journey, and only you hold the key. All right.
Thank you.
C. Henson, WHUR 96.3. Mr. Carl C. Henson.
I'm enjoying this. How about you so far? God bless you. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. And before we let this lovely lady leave the podium, she's a member of the Jewels. And I want you all to think about, you know the Jewels, don't you? She's an old and dear friend. Forget the word old, just an old dear friend. And she's a lovely lady, so let's give her another round of applause. And I am thrilled. How'd you like those MC steppers? Didn't they do a great job? Come on. Thank you so much. This is my second year here, and it's a blessing to be here and see so much energy, so many people here supporting their families and their loved ones. We thank you so much for coming out tonight. As you can see, our theme for this afternoon is Keys of Life, with help from the music of Mr. Stevie Wonder. Stevie is a genius. At this time, it's my pleasure to bring to the stage the executive director of the DC Office on Aging, Laura Newman. She was recently appointed by Mayor Merrill Browser to lead the agency that provides programs and services for residents 60 years of age and older and people 18 years of age and older living with disabilities and caregivers. I had the pleasure of working with her and know that she is a great advocate. She's a wonderful person for the residents that she serves. Please welcome my good friend, Laura Newman.
Hi, good afternoon. I want to thank you all for coming here today and supporting our contestants. And before we begin, I really want to say, wow, that was quite a show, wasn't it? Those MC Steppers. The first time I saw them, I thought, I never understood the term showstopper before. But they are really something else. And I didn't think Stevie Wonder needed any help to look any better, but he sure looks better today, doesn't he? Before we begin, I do want to make a note. We are a little subdued here today because one of our own members, Ms. Nancy Berry, who was Miss Senior DC 2013, passed away suddenly recently. And many of you knew her. I know many of our Cameo Club, they grew to love her. And many of my staff knew her and worked very closely with her. So I just want to take a moment to reflect on everything that she gave us at the DC Office on Aging and really for the District of Columbia. And we want to say thank you, Nancy. Wherever you are, I know she is looking down on us today and making sure we got all our steps right. So as you all know, we have 10 contestants here today. I am so thrilled to be a part of this project. And I want to thank our partners at the University of District of Columbia for sharing this space with us and for allowing us to hold this wonderful event. I think, don't tell anybody, but I think this is one of our best events of the year, don't you think? So we are really looking forward. The theme is Keys of Life, and if this is what aging looks like, sign us all up, right? All right, so sit back, enjoy the show. I know we have some great, great things planned for you today, and thank you all again for showing your support of what aging really looks like. Thanks so much.
Let's give another round of applause. She's the backbone of this situation here today, and we're so happy that we are able to do this contest. This is my second year, as I said, and each year it gets better and better and better. Now, we turn to the DC Commission on Aging chairperson, Romaine Thomas. She serves as an advisor to the mayor and the Office on Aging on issues concerning, of course, older adults in the community. She will come to the stage and bring greetings. My good friend, please welcome her, Romaine.
This is quite a bright light here. But first of all, let me say that I am very pleased to be here, and I'm glad to see that so many of you are here. So I do need to say good afternoon to all, and that it gives me great pleasure to bring you greetings on behalf of the DC Commission on Aging. And I think we may have some of the commissioners here. I know I did see Commissioner Grellis here. She's sitting up front, and if there are other commissioners, please stand and let it be known that your presence is here, that you're here. Wonderful. Commissioner Moore, thank you so much. But I did say greetings to you, but at the same time, there is a sad note to my message, and I hope I take the privilege to share this with you. But we're so happy that we're here to celebrate as we remember Nancy Berry, who was one of our former queens. I want us to let it be known that we celebrate today in her spirit. So could everybody for one moment just give a moment of silence? Thank you. We all remember what she stood for and her talent, her grace, and her passion and support will never be forgotten. And she brought so much to this program, and I know that she was looking forward to coming to share with us today. I hope many of you remember her. If not, in the days to come, I'm sure that you will give that recognition. Let me close by saying I congratulate all of the contestants and recognize their hard work. And I also am very pleased that they were able to step forward and bring joy to seniors by sponsoring and having this particular program and by sharing their talents inside and outside beauty. We look for beauty, but we look for beauty, the internal beauty as well as the outside beauty. And they have both, so we're very pleased that they're here to share that with us. But let me say all the best to all of the participants, and indeed to all of the people who did such hard work to bring this program to us, especially the Cameo Club, and especially those employers who are with the Office on Aging. We want to give them a round of applause and salute them for stepping forward and making this possible. So enjoy the program. Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to bring to the stage a good friend of mine. We've known each other for a while, at least maybe 30 years. She's a wonderful, wonderful lady. She is Miss Senior DC, Wendy Denise Bridges. She is a satin doll who enjoys being a girl because she simply just feels good. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Senior DC, Wendy Denise Bridges. See why she won, you know what I'm saying? Let's give her another round of applause. Man, this is, you know, I was telling my lady friend, this is just a pleasure for me to come here just to see the excitement and the energy that these young ladies, and I'm calling them young ladies, put out on this stage. And I think if you applaud a little louder when they're out here, I think you'll do even better. So let's give them a generous round of applause when they come out here. Okay? Now, we're going to begin our first segment of competition. Now, take in mind that the contestants will be scored on their talent. The talent is worth 30% of their scoring for today. Now, our first contestant is Rebecca Ann Washington. Got a fan club, okay? You've heard this song many times, I know I have, but you've never heard it sung quite like this. Presented now because she sings it from her heart. It's from The Wiz, entitled Home. Let's welcome to the stage Rebecca Washington, contestant number one.
Yeah.
feeling we've got it up here. Our next performer will make you want to kind of get out of your seats and join her as she takes the stage with the original creative movement dance to the song entitled, I'm Good. Put your hands together for Leontine Houston.
People say, Tim, you're my hero. How you do it? How you stay strong? Let them all know there's so much that I've been through. I have my days when it's true, y'all. I just can't smile. I just won't cry. It ain't easy. Sometimes it's work just to be alive. But when I think, cause the goodness that's come to me, it's easier to let go. That I'm not having it. Just take a good look in the mirror and say to yourself, I've come to fight to quit. So say I'm good, good enough to love myself. So good, good enough to have success. What you need from all the stress? Just the freedom to know that you are blessed. I'm good, good enough to handle my bills. So good, good enough to raise my kids. My people, let me tell you, and I'ma say it loud and clear. You listen, so you hear me, so you never will forget. You're good enough to get that job. You're good enough to drive that car. And on top of all these things, you're good enough to have your dreams. Yeah, yeah. Ooh, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, come on, let me hear you say, people say, Tim, you're my hero. How you do it? How you stay strong?
Talking about a lot of talent. We've got it up here this evening. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the next contestant shares her passion for the challenges faced by disabled individuals. And I think that's a great thing. Listen carefully. Listen carefully and enjoy the monologue as Iris Johnson, contestant number 3, gives excellent advice on how to help others. Let's give a round of applause.
Wouldn't you want love, respect, and to be cared for?
Wow. All kinds of talent up here, I tell you. Okay, now, are you ready for this? Our next contestant is ready to face the music as she sings her version of the sultry tune, Teach Me Tonight. I present to you Dr. Julianne Andrews, contestant number 4. Let's give a round of applause.
Da, 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 da.
Wow. Doctors can sing too, right? You know, each contestant is different. That's what's amazing about this whole. Let's give them all a round of applause thus far. I think this is, man. Now, this next lady is kind of what I call jazzing it up with her piano rendition of Don't Get Around Much Anymore. That's from Sophisticated Lady by Duke Ellington. And of course, Bob Basie. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Billy Laverne Smith, contestant number 5. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, time now to clap your hands, tap your feet, stomp, do what you want to do. Enjoy the twisting sensation who loves performing to Let's Twist Again by Chubby Checker. Come on, welcome Elvira Patrick, contestant number 6. know I can do that. Psych. Yeah, right. Mess myself up or something. Let's give another round of applause. That was great. Every one of these contestants just continues to amaze me. They wanted me to come to rehearsal last week, and I said, no. I want to be excited, and just like the audience, and I want to see what's going on, and I'm just thrilled, and I know you are as well. Our next contestant will be presenting her original historical writing entitled Queens, which starts with the past and takes us to the present. Please give a warm welcome to Eleanor Hooker Heron, contestant number 7.
Their towns. They knew who they were, and nothing could put them down. They were regal in their walk and in their talk. When we strut, people stop and stare. And of course, the men, they just stop and gawk. What is it? What happened to our elegant way of walking and talking and being? What is it that our young sisters are seeing that makes them think it's cool, it's okay, it's hip to be called unflattering names as they come through the door? Don't they realize, don't they even recognize that they're worth so much more? You're all queens. You've got queenly blood running through your veins. For that, you should never be ashamed. Know thyself. You come from a long line of honor, strength, beauty, and intellect. I stand before you today as an answer, a proud answer to my ancestors' prayer. I am proud, prayerful, free. I exhibit strength, beauty, honor, and intellect. I am fearfully made, fearfully and wonderfully made, and grateful to God that he has allowed me to have the promise of 70. Remember, you're all queens. You just need to remember who you really are.
I told you that everything was a little different, so you're going to see a variety of talent up here, and I think it's all fantastic. Okay, we're getting down to the bottom line now. This is contestant number 8, Diane Mackey. Our next contestant is very capable as a comedian known as Lady Di. She will certainly tickle your funny bone. I'm looking forward to that. That's wonderful because she says that laughter is good for the soul. Let's find out if that's true, okay? Sit back, listen, and laugh with Diane Mackey, contestant number 8. Diane.
About 50 people swindling. famous voice say, read all about it, read all about it. 51 people speak.
Wow. I don't know whether to laugh or cry on that one, man.
It's still on. Yes.
Woo. I told you, this is an experience. Now, if you like the blues, you'll enjoy the next act. The contestant does a seductive dance to the tune of December Blues. Her dance was choreographed by her niece, Miss Alexandra. So give it up, folks, for Jessica Franklin, contestant number 9.
Thank you.
Contestant will present an original poem written in the memory of her mother entitled Dance. So sit back and enjoy the dance to the beat of I Hope You Dance by Gladys Knight, performed by Janice Patterson, contestant number 10. Let's give her a round of applause.
Yourself, to reach beyond yourself, to feel the vibrations of life, to taste the deepness of breath deep down inside. Dance, dance. Closeness has no distance. Together we dance, and we dance. And we dance. Reach back for me and dance. Stay beside the stars reflecting from the light and shine, shine, shine and dance. I hope you dance and stand in your own soul.
Wow, that's just the first part. So we got a little ways to go, but and the judges are tabulating. It's gonna be very interesting. I'd like to bring to the stage our previous pageant winners. These are ladies who have represented the district as Miss Senior DC. The full listing is on your program. Let's start with 1998. I hope I have this right. Elaine Terry, Miss Terry. Thank you. 1999, Thelma Morgan, Miss Morgan. Don't they look lovely? Just come on, let's keep the applause coming. From 2002, Daisy Savage. Ann Thomas. Oh, I almost forgot this. From 2005, my good friend Sandra Bear. Let's give her a round of applause. From 2007, six. Okay, I'm sorry. From 2006, Ann Thomas. Okay. From Watson, Miss Lucille Watson. And we skip now to 2010, I believe. Sheila Poole, Miss Sheila Poole, 2010. Miss Emma Ward, Miss Ward. 2012, Mary McCoy, Miss Mary McCoy. 1992, Miss Doris Thompson. Where's Miss Doris Thomas? Thomas. Miss Doris Thomas. And from 2014, Miss Toni Jackson. Miss Jackson. Let's give them all a round of applause, ladies. Ellen Van Edwards, Miss Edwards. So let's give them a round of applause, please, for beautiful ladies. Thank you so much, ladies. Thank you for the wonderful, wonderful guests that join us today. We turn now pretty soon to our next and final segment of competition. And you know, this is going to be quite interesting. Of course, the judges are working very diligently to make sure that we have a good, good tally of what's happening up here this evening. Our next and final segment of competition is the evening gown competition and philosophy of life. The contestants will be judged on their poise and, of course, their elegance as they grace the stage. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our first contestant, Rebecca Ann Washington. Miss Rebecca Ann Washington. Rebecca Ann Washington, born in Virginia, crowned homecoming queen at Cardoza High School. Her pursuit of higher education has taken her to American University School of Business, Georgetown University, where she studied and became a paralegal and a licensed beautician. She owned and operated several salons and spas and worked in the beauty industry. Please welcome her to the stage. And she's escorted by Donovan Sandoval. Let's give a round of applause to her.
Because of the heritage and the legacy of my ancestors, it has made me the woman that I am today. It has inspired my love for God and humanity with faith, hope, and charity. It is my dream to be the best person that I can be, to be kind, honest, and generous. My foundation is built on the sweat and tears to know that when you believe in Jesus Christ, there are no limitations.
Contestant number two is Leotine Houston. Please welcome her to the stage.
Agree to disagree with the sharing of feelings, the telling the truth, the ending of anger, and the healing of judgment, with the willingness to listen and the willingness to speak, with the decision to forgive and the choice to release, with the commitment to give and the grace to receive. When it's all said and done, love is what we need.
Is a native Washingtonian who attended Howard University and later trained in the nursing field and physical therapy. She worked at Gladys Spellman Hospital, where she received several awards for outstanding work. After retirement, she began volunteering with seniors under National Caucus and Center for Black Age, where she works with Terrific Incorporated. Contestant number two. Escorted by her Minister Michael Austin. Contestant number three, Iris Johnson, a native Washingtonian. Let's give her a round of applause. Iris Johnson.
Child of God. I enjoy helping the disabled adult. Gospel music is my passion. I made sure I taught my son to want to help others. I now work for Volunteers of America Chesapeake, which is a great, awesome experience.
Ms. Johnson, after 32 years in the Marine Corps, worked for the federal government. Then she began her work with kids at local daycares and preschools. She enjoys working with disabled adults, which she says is an awesome experience. A missionary at her church, St. John Seamy, she also has one son who's married and a biological granddaughter. She's escorted by acquaintance James Thomas. Contestant number three, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Julian Andrews.
proud of her. The accomplishments that she's made, the woman that she's become. Now, she's made some mistakes, but she's owned every one of them. I think that she still has dreams and aspirations that can still be success stories. There's an old saying, life begins at 40. Not necessarily. Life begins at 71. And if you don't believe it, just watch.
Dr. Andrews was born in St. John, Antigua. She came to the U.S. at the age of 10 and attended D.C. public schools, a graduate of Roosevelt High School. She received a minority education grant through the University of Chicago in nursing and later became interested in medicine and attended George Washington University and obtained her medical degree, completing a residency at Roosevelt Hospital in New York. She helped design a walk-in clinic at Providence Hospital and later opened her own practice in Northeast DC. She was escorted by Albertus McCray Jr. They've been friends since they were 15 years old. That's a lot of time, right? Contestant number 5 is Billy Laverne Smith. Miss Smith.
Gives each and every one of us talents, also called gifts and blessings. These gifts are not meant for us to keep for ourselves. They are meant to be shared with others. I see this as an infinity circle. God sends us blessings. We in turn use these blessings to bless others. God is pleased and sends us even more blessings. Think about it. Have you blessed anyone today? It's not too late.
Smith was born in Chicago, Illinois, grew up in Lynchburg, and came to D.C. to attend Howard University, where she majored in psychology. Fell in love with D.C. and stayed and received a master's degree from George Washington in human resource management. Since graduating from school, she has been directing choirs at Trinity AME Zion Church. She worked in public health with the federal government, active in her church and in her sorority, Delta Sigma Theta. She has led the chapter choir and held positions of leadership. He has various other affiliations and loves music and travel. Escorted by her cousin, Joseph Clayton Ward IV. Okay, now we turn to contestant number 6, Elvira Patrick. Let's give her a round of applause.
Hi, children are our future. It takes a village to raise one. And if you teach one, we would have better future leaders. You just can't talk the talk. You have to walk the walk. Children need to be treated with respect to learn respect. They look up to us, so we need to do the right thing. As seniors, it is our responsibility.
Contestant number six, Ms. Patrick. After graduation, this native Washingtonian moved to Richmond, Virginia, where she attended school and received an associate's degree in child development and served, of course, as a teacher's aide. Later, she became director and CEO of a child development center there. She returned to DC, where she opened a daycare in her home. Ms. Patrick loves children, enjoys telling stories. She also performs for them, and she does a lot for the founding of the Royal Tea Events, where she hosts tea parties for the young and old to model proper etiquette. Wonderful. She learned to sew at the age of 12 as a creative seamstress and a designer. She creates designs for a fashion show, her family, and does a great job. Crowned Miss Senior Congress Heights in 2013, she served award with great pride and dignity. She is escorted by her grandson, Millard Watkins. This is exciting. Eleanor Hooker Heron is contestant number seven. Let's give her a round of applause if you will.
To have our life, our being, and our movement. I believe that each one of you is God's breath. And because of that, I must always speak and act accordingly. Because God's not going to ask me how you treat me. He's going to ask me how I treat you.
Ms. Heron is a fourth-generation Washingtonian who attended private schools, including a boarding school in Pennsylvania. She attended Howard University and Hancock University, receiving a bachelor's and master's in child development and social welfare, respectively, and later worked at D.C. government for 25 years for various programs with at-risk youth. Her grant writing landed her various opportunities for the youth to enrich their lives through activities, technology, and many other things. She retired in 2006, ready for travel and to chill away with the kids. She attends Union Temple, where she is active and her mind, body, and soul and ethnic spirit are nurtured. She trained under Yana Van Zandt as a life coach and enjoys entertaining, traveling, socializing. Her escort is Anthony Frost, her firstborn nephew. Test contestant number 8 is Diane Mackey. Let's give her a round of applause.
I greet everyone I see with a smile. You see, my smile is a gift from God. When I smile, it's like the sun bursting through the clouds. I smile in hopes that it will lighten someone's spirit. How much does it cost you to smile? I smile.
Ms. Mackey is a native Washingtonian who attended the public schools and pursued her education, where she graduated from Southeastern University. Recipient of the Student Honors Award from the Association of Government Accountants, she later graduated summa cum laude for the Computer Learning Center of Alexandria, Virginia. After 20 years of government service, she obtained her real estate license. Let's give a round of applause to her. Albertus McCray. Our next contestant is Jessica Hayes Franklin. Let's give her a round of applause, if you will.
In your life that count. It's the life in your years that count. I aim to enrich these years by inspiring hope in our next generation. These precious years shape their future. I can and will invest in them my time, my talent, my wisdom, and resources. I want them to redeem the time. My motivation, love.
This young lady is a native Washingtonian, demonstrating her passion and commitment to housing community development in the District of Columbia for more than 40 years, with professional service at both federal and local levels. She retired from the federal government after 27 years of service as a manager for the District of Columbia, U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development. Jessica's deep Washington, D.C. roots include education at St. Martin's Catholic School, Langley Junior High School, and Dunbar Senior High School. She earned a bachelor's degree in mathematics from the University of Denver and a master's degree in economics from George Washington University. Her pride and joy is her grandnephew, whom she raised from the age of 18, who is now in college. She is a lifetime member of the Greater Leadership in Washington. Let's give contestant number 9 a round of applause. Turning now to contestant number 10, Denise Jo Patterson. Let's give a round of applause.
Choose God again and again, never losing the capacity to love, never putting value in man, using my life as a testimony, knowing the life given to me to love and heal others, pouring you in me. Deep inside, walking in gratefulness, anointed, not appointed, honor and fearlessness to serve God.
Ms. Patterson is anchored in strength, poise, and with grace, as you can see. Community echoes her praises. She is a steadfast and unmovable reputation for empowering families. Ms. Patterson established Bring a Parent in 1978. Referral clearinghouse for parents and students. 3 decades of zealous empowerment was the catalyst for Parent Watch Incorporated, founded in 1990, an advocacy group that works with parents and their children to ensure that their rights are protected. She has worked tirelessly for the well-being of the underserved. Her philosophy is, heal a parent, heal a child, heal a family. A devoted mother of two, a grandmother, 2 grandchildren, Ms. Patterson's lifestyle personifies unconditional love and compassion for others. Let's give her a round of applause. Contestants, a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. And now it's my pleasure to introduce to you, for a farewell address, Miss Senior DC, my good friend, Wendy D. Bridges. Let's give her a round of applause.
Good afternoon. Now you know I got to put on my glasses, right? It has been a great privilege, a profound honor, and especially gratifying to represent the seniors of Washington, D.C. as Miss Senior D.C. 2015. Philippians 4:13 states, I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. And keeping that in mind, I was willing to begin this fantastic journey. In my philosophy of life, I mentioned that I was a lifelong learner, and being crowned as queen afforded me many golden opportunities to do just that, learn. I learned how fantastic and beautiful seniors really are. We are, aren't we? Yes, we are. We're warm, we're kind, we're talented, we're loving, and we are superb athletes. And I am overly proud to be one. Has it really been a year? Where did the time go? Well, let me share some of my highlights with you of my reign. My reign began with the annual Palisades Parade on the 4th of July with our illustrious mayor, Mayor Muriel Bowser, along with my two best buddies, Frances Johnson, first runner-up, and Sylvia Gaither, second runner-up. Also with city council officials. Love you. Then on to performing in showcases with the Cameo Club, speaking engagements, and numerous hospitals, senior centers, schools, recreation centers, and local organizations. This was also my first experience with the DC Senior Olympic Games, which I found quite invigorating and lots of fun. Following that, visiting various wellness centers who sponsored very informative health and fitness fairs. Many times during my reign, I was invited to speak extemporaneously, and that was a learning experience in itself. The ultimate experience of my reign, ladies and gentlemen, was when I went to the Nationals in Atlantic City, New Jersey. The pageant for Miss Senior America. It was awesome. I was treated like royalty. I made lifelong friends, and I became a walking rhinestone. I mean, bling was everywhere. You know what I mean? Oh, it was wonderful. Another fantastic learning experience. You know, being Miss Senior DC has definitely been life-changing. You feel like a celebrity. There were many opportunities to meet wonderful people all over the city, taking many photographs, appearing on television, in the local newspapers, and I even got a chance to ride on the new streetcar. I also presented to young people, and I reminded them that we want to utilize our morals and our values at all times. Seniors, I believe that it is our obligation and our responsibility to continue to pass on those old-fashioned morals and values that we were raised on. To paraphrase Dorothy Height, who said, "We all have to help one another. We cannot afford to be separate. We must see that we are all in the same boat." In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, I have to give thanks and praise to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for without his glorious guidance, none of this could have been possible. I must also acknowledge and thank my court, the Dynamic Seven, our former queens, our wonderful Cameo Club, my mentors, the late Yvonne Johnson and Tony Jackson, Miss Senior DC 2014, the DC Department on Aging, the DC Commission on Aging, Mayor Muriel Bowser, the Department of Parks and Recreation, Family Matters, the MC Steppers, the Lamont Senior Seekers, my church, Mount Carmel Baptist, my supportive and loving family, love you guys, my wonderful friends, my neighbors, and the amazing seniors that I have had the opportunity to serve and represent here in my beloved, loved city of Washington, D.C. I want to thank each and every one of you from the bottom of my heart. It has been a wonderful, wonderful journey. A queen is out.
Precious to us all, but if you let me be your weapon, sin of you. among the dream with spirits, no pipe. Though you're in life condition, it's far from being alright. Your love is strong and your money's gone. You lost your home and everything you own. But before you do something, make an exchange. I've got one simple thing for you to take along with you. If you go home, you're only waiting. Tomorrow, robins will sing. Tomorrow, robins will sing. It really is no big
deal. Let's give another round. Wow. Oh, really? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce Miss Darlene Nolan, DC State, DC?
Yes.
Pageant director, my good friend.
Hello, everyone. I hope you're enjoying this great show. I wanted to take this time out to call out Miss Wendy Bridges. Can you come back to the stage, please? On behalf of all of the citizens of the District of Columbia, we appreciate all that you have done this year. You have been an excellent ambassador. You have been all across this city riding streetcars and doing everything else. And we appreciate it, but we wanted to take this time to present these flowers to you. And this plaque presented to Wendy D. Bridges, Miss Senior District of Columbia 2015, under the pageant theme, Women in the Mirror. You remember that, don't you? Many of you were here. Thank you for sharing, thank you for serving as our gracious ambassador, Miss Senior District of Columbia Planning Committee, Darlene Allen, District of Columbia State Pageant Director, District of Columbia Office on Aging.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Enjoy the show.
At the beginning of our Keys of Life presentation for the Miss Senior DC Pageant, we did not introduce the DC Seniors Cameo Club Vice President. So I'd like for you to give her a warm welcome at this time. So please welcome to the podium Judy L. Terry, Vice President, DC Seniors Cameo Club. Miss Terry.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the DC Cameo Club, I welcome you to 2016 Miss Senior DC Pageant. The DC Cameo Club is an organization made up of women 60 years and older who has completed the title of Miss Senior DC. In addition to working with seniors of various projects through the year, each summer, along with the Office on Aging, we present Miss Senior DC Pageant to crown a Miss Senior DC. This is an event that we enjoy, and many of you join us each year. This task may be extremely difficult this year for us. In the passing, this past Monday, the president of the Cameo Club, Nancy Berry, she was Miss Senior DC 2013. Nancy was a co-chairperson and the planning and implementing of the pageant. She works tirelessly and conditionally to ensure the success. We are devastated by the loss of Nancy, but we choose to remember the best of her life with us. That will not be difficult for those participating in the pageant today. We know that life ends, but memories live. Each of us are committed to make this pageant that Nancy envisioned. We love Nancy, and she is missed. We have much to remember about her. I ask that you join me in a moment of silent prayer to remember Nancy. Amen. Thank you.
Okay, I think you're ready for the winner, aren't you? Just a moment. Bear with me. Let's welcome back to the stage for a final performance. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed their first one. This one is going to knock you out. Ladies and gentlemen, the MC Steppers will perform. Let's give them a round of applause.
This time.
2016, Miss Senior DC, I tell you, this has been, I tell you, this is an awesome, awesome event. Before we go any further, I'd like for you to give yourselves a round of applause. You've been a beautiful audience. Thank you so much for coming out. And thank you for coming out and supporting these wonderful ladies that have performed, that have recited, have just done a fantastic job. And I think they all look fantastic. Let's give them all a round of applause. So now, it is time to bring back to the stage our contestants. So please greet them accordingly. Contestant number one, Rebecca Ann Washington. Let's hear it for her. Contestant number two, Leotine Houston. Contestant number three, Iris Johnson. Miss Johnson. Contestant number four, Dr. Juden Andrews. Contestant number five, Billy Laverne Smith. And contestant number six is Elvira Patrick. Miss Patrick. Contestant number seven, Eleanor Hooker Heron. Miss Heron. Contestant number eight, Diane Mackey. Let's give her a round of applause. Contestant number nine, Jessica Haynes Franklin. And finally, contestant number 10, Janice Jo Patterson. Let's give all of the contestants another round of applause. Aren't they beautiful? And I understand there's a very special serenade by Mr. Philip Nelson. Mr. Nelson.
Hello. Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to thank my friend Sheila Poole, Miss Senior DC 2010, for introducing me to the pageant. And it's an honor to serenade such distinguished contestants and audience with a classic Stevie Wonder song.
Time when I get nervous. I'm not going to pull a Steve Harvey on you, though. He's a friend of mine, so that's okay. Works at WHUR. We love him. But I'm not going to do that, all right? It's time now. And first of all, thank you so much for your patience. this is one of those situations where we try to do the best, and this young lady standing next to me has done a fantastic job. I want to give her some love. You have no idea.
We also want to make sure that we acknowledge Miss Gwendolyn Coleman. Honorary Senior America, Miss Gwendolyn Coleman, who worked with this committee for several years. Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We got work to do here. Okay, here we go. Now we present the award for the best interview, the ballots. Oh, best salesperson? Okay, all right. For the best salesperson, here we go. And the winner is, I need a razor blade or something to do this with. Best salesperson. Contestant number 7, Eleanor Heron. Miss Heron. Congratulations. Great job selling tickets. And you know, judging from all the audience here, we did a fantastic job. Once again, let's give her a round of applause. Fantastic. And now, the award for best interview. The ballots have been sealed and we'll announce the winner. And the winner for the best interview. Wish we had a drum roll, really. Contestant number 5, Miss Billie Laverne Smith. And this is my favorite part right here. Best evening gown. Here we go. This is going to be interesting. Wow. Contestant number 9, Miss Jessica Haynes Franklin. Okay, here we go. Best talent. Contestant number 5, Miss Billie Laverne Smith. As we know, in any beauty pageant, this one and many, many others, there's always a favorite among all the contestants, and they vote among themselves for a person they think is the most congenial, the nicest, the sweetest, the most engaging, and that person is Miss Congeniality, and we will name that person as soon as we get this envelope open, and that person is... Contestant number 6. Miss Elvira Patrick, Miss Congeniality. Okay, now the fun begins. First is the third runner up. Contestant number 7, Miss Elnora R. Heron. Contestant number 7, the third runner-up. Mm-hmm. This is exciting, actually, I'm telling you. Are you guys excited? I don't know. All right, second runner-up. Wait, okay. Drum roll. Can y'all make a drum noise for me? Thank you so much. Second runner up, Miss Juden Dr. Juden Andrews. All right, here we go. Just a minute. Aren't these ladies beautiful? Let's give them all a round of applause. Okay, help me with the drum roll again. First runner-up. Contestant number 9, Miss Jessica Haynes Franklin. Miss Senior DC 2016 for the Miss Senior DC pageant. Contestant number 5, Miss Billie Laverne Smith. Let's hear it for her.